So let's take a look at some examples of functions. So constant function. A constant function is a function where no matter what the input, the output is always a constant. So for example, let's say f of x equals 5. This is a constant function because no matter what the input, replace x with 2/3, output is 5. If I replace x with 100, f of 100 is 5. F of -3456 is 5, and f of a plus h is 5. So no matter what the input, the output is always 5. So that's why it's called a constant function. Can you think of a constant function of your own? Go ahead, pause the video and create your own constant function. All right, square root function. The output is the square root of the input. So the domain would be all non-negative real numbers, because if you have a negative real number, you know it's going to be imaginary numbers. So if you want a real valued function, you have to restrict the input to all positive, zero and positive real numbers. That's why we say non-negative, because zero is allowed. So if I wrote g of x equals square root x, then I'm going to have g of whatever is going to be square root of whatever. So if I insert 2/3, then it'll be square root 2/3. If so, 2/3, it's what's replacing the x. This is very important that you know what you're replacing. So g of 100 would be square root of 100, which you know is 10. So it's a little review of previous concepts. G of 3456 would be square root of 3456. All right, let's take a different function we call exponential function, where the input x is a real number, but the output is a particular number raised to the exponent of x. All right, so e of x equals, say, 2 to the x. So then we're going to have e of 2/3 is going to equal 2 to the power 2/3. All right, let's see. E of 100 would be 2 to the 100. E of negative 3456 would be 2 to the power of negative 3456. E of a plus h would be 2 to the power a plus h. So just see how every time we replace this x with something, it goes and takes place of the exponent. That's what the exponential function is. Polynomial function, so clearly the x must represent the input and the output is a polynomial. So for example, p of x equals 3x squared minus 5x plus 7. This is a second degree polynomial function, a one variable. You know, we're talking about one variable functions, but you can always make functions of multivariables. That's perfectly fine also. Then the input will be not just one number, but ordered pairs or triplets or how many variables you have. So p of 2 in this case, you're replacing the x with 2s. So 3 times 2 squared minus 5 times 2 plus 7. And then you evaluate it, which will give you p of 2 to be 9. P of 0, replace x with 0, so p of 0 would be 7. P of a plus h. So what are you going to do? Remember, wherever you have x, you're going to replace those with a plus h, and that will be your answer. Rational function, as the word suggests, it's going to be what? A quotient. You're going to have a numerator, denominator. So a rational function is a function where the numerator is a polynomial, denominator is a polynomial, and the input will be all values of x that make denominator non-zero. So if you look here, x minus 1 is the denominator, and 1 will make this a 0. 1 minus 1 is 0 on the denominator, which we cannot have. So the condition would have to be that x has to be not equal to 1. All real numbers, so that x is not equal to 1, is going to be the domain of this rational function. In order to evaluate it, if you want r of 4, replace all the x's with 4s and you end up with 13/3. A plus h, just replace all the x's with a plus h. Here's your homework. See what you can do. Here are some questions we would like you to think about.